Hi everyone, so this video is for those of you who are brand new to the Mac ecosystem, or even for those of you that have owned a Mac for a while, but you just want to sort of streamline the way that you use it. And in this video, I'm going to show you some tips and tricks that is going to make your Mac ownership experience even better. Now, without further ado, getting straight into it, the first thing I wanted to show you is for those of you that use external monitors. So you might not be able to see in the background of this video, but I do have my M1 MacBook Air hooked up to a Dell external display. Now, if we actually come into the Apple logo in the top right-hand corner, we click System Preferences, and then we go into Displays. What I'll do is I'll actually drag this onto my external monitor so you can see it a little bit easier. And see, if we go to arrangement, we can obviously move all of this around. So if you have your monitor off to the right or off to the left, that's totally fine. You can switch this up. But a lot of people don't realize that there's this little white bar here, and you can actually click and hold and drag this little white bar onto each monitor. And as you can see there, once we change it over to this particular monitor, it now means that we have the menu bar on this monitor, and this is essentially our main monitor. And this is a very helpful feature because if you sit in front of your monitor and you have your laptop off to the side, for example, sometimes it's easy just to have all of these menu bars on your main monitor that's right in front of you. Now, the second feature that most of you probably know about, but I'm sure almost all of you underutilize, is the Spotlight search. So a quick keyboard shortcut is Command and Space. That's going to bring up Spotlight search on your computer. Now, obviously, you can use this to search for files and all that kind of stuff within the hard drive or the SSD of your Mac. But a lot of people don't know that you can actually do a lot more with the Spotlight search. So, for example, some multiplication and mathematics. So you can see there, you can do 50 times 50 or whatever you want. You can do subtraction. So it will also go into negatives. You can also go somewhat more complicated. So you can start adding in brackets here. And you'll see there, it'll calculate it very, very easily with no problems. And this has saved me probably hours over the years. I don't have to go to my phone or open up a different app. I literally just click Command, Space, type in my equation, works it out for me straight away. You can also do the same with currency. So I live in Australia and I spend a lot of time translating between different currencies, mainly from Australian dollars to US dollars and vice versa. And this just makes it super easily. So let's say, for example, someone sends me 500 US dollars. I can just type in 500 USD to AUD and it will do the calculation right there. It'll take it from Yahoo Finance. So this is the most up-to-date exchange rate. And you can see there at the moment, 500 US dollars is 644 Australian dollars. You can obviously do almost any currency you want. So we can do 500 yen to AUD or US dollars or Great British Pounds. And it's gonna do all of those calculations right in Spotlight search for you. The other thing I use Spotlight search for is launching apps. So you can literally just type in the first few letters, and then if you wanted to launch it, you literally just press return on the keyboard, and that is going to open up the application. It saves you a lot of time if you don't have it on your desktop or it's not a frequently used app. You don't have to go into Finder and then search for it in the applications. It's just right there, ready to go. Now, a lot of people really underappreciate the benefit of the preview application. So if you're sent a contract or you're signing something, you need to do an e-signature, just open up preview and you can sign it there very easily. So let's say, for example, I'm taking a screenshot of a document and I need to sign it and email it to someone. By the way, screenshot shortcuts, super easy. On the keyboard, Command-Shift-3 for the entire display, or 4 if you want to select something. So we'll just do Command-Shift-4 and we'll select this part. And if you open up that particular screenshot or document or PDF or whatever you're using, and you open it up using preview, you can come up here to the tools and you can come to annotate, and then you can click signature. And then as you can see there, I've got my own personal signature, or you can click manage signatures if you don't have one, and you can either create one on your trackpad, camera, or phone. Now, this is probably easier on the phone, but let's just do for the trackpad just for the purpose of this video. If I click there to begin, you literally just sign on the trackpad, and then you just press any key when finished, and then done. And now, as you can see, I can come here, I can click that, and I can now drag that onto any location or any PDF or file I want to on my Mac. And when I exit out of this, And if I load it back up, by the way, really quick preview just to load something up really quickly, spacebar, press the spacebar, you can see there that it is now saved. And I can now send this to my workplace or my bank or wherever it needs to go. Now, this next tip is something I used to use all the time at my previous 9-to-5 job, and it is hot corners. Now, some of you might find this really useful around the house. Let's say, for example, if you live with kids or you have siblings and you don't want them to be able to access your computer easily, you can set up your hot corners to make it very easy for you to lock the screen. Now, coming back to system preferences, we're going to go to desktop and screensaver, and we're going to make sure we are on the screensaver tab. We're going to come down here and we're going to click hot corners, and you can see that you've got a couple of different options here. So the main one I use is lock screen. So I'm going to set that to the bottom right hand corner. We're going to click OK. Now, as you can see here on the trackpad, I'm going to put the mouse into the bottom right hand corner. And as you can see, that's going to lock the screen, and you have to enter your password to be able to get back into it, which is really handy, especially at work. If you need to leave your desk for a minute or two to grab a coffee or do something like that, you can literally just hover your mouse down in the bottom right-hand corner or whichever corner you choose. It's going to lock the screen and you can just walk away very, very easily. Now, there are other options. So if we come back into hot corners and we say, for example, change the top right-hand corner to mission control, I'm going to click OK. If I put the mouse in the top right-hand corner, it's going to show me the mission control. Or we can also select another one of my personal favorites, application windows. So now, for example, if we have multiple windows open and we move the mouse up to the top right-hand corner, you can see there that it gives us an immediate view of all of our open windows. And we can come in here, we can select one if we want. But that's a very, very handy feature to have. Now, another really cool feature is desktops. Now, this can be accessed by either pressing the F3 button or using three fingers to swipe up on your trackpad. Now, what this allows you to do is add multiple kind of desktops that you can scroll through, and this makes it really, really handy for multitasking. So say, for example, on desktop one, if I wanted to have Apple Music open, if I now use my three fingers to swipe across to desktop two, I can, for example, have the Maps application open. And then if I wanted to, I can come here and I can add a third desktop by clicking the plus button up in the top right-hand corner. And that's going to add a fourth desktop, which is going to allow me to pretty much do whatever I want. And I can access all of this with just three fingers swiping across on the trackpad. Now, if you are using a desktop Mac, like a Mac Mini, you can do the same thing. You just got to hold down Control and then use the arrow keys to swipe left or right. It works the exact same way, but again, it's much easier with the trackpad. Three fingers up, you can see all your desktops, you can delete them, you can add more, and it's very, very great for multitasking. Now, the last point I wanted to talk about isn't exactly software specific. It's actually to do with refurbished Apple products. So if you didn't know, Apple will refurbish a lot of its returned or faulty products, and they'll actually be able to resell them. And one of the huge advantages of buying a refurbished product from Apple is you're going to save quite a lot of money. So on average, it's 10 to 15% cheaper buying a refurbished Apple product. And there really aren't any downsides. So all the refurbished products come with a 1-year warranty or whatever warranty you have in your particular country. In Australia, we also have consumer law, so the Macs will come with that as well. They're fully tested by Apple technicians, so even more so than the brand new product. It's been put through stress testing, physical inspections. Apple technicians have given it the all clear. It's also thoroughly cleaned and sterilized. And it's repackaged with brand new packaging. I personally try to buy refurbished Macs whenever I can from Apple. At the company I worked for last, we had to upgrade everyone with new MacBook Airs. I bought about 4 or 5 refurbished MacBook Airs. They all work perfectly even to this day. So there really aren't any negatives to going down that route. The big upside, of course, is you're going to be saving potentially hundreds of dollars. Anyway, guys, that's it for this video. Hope you found these little tips and tricks helpful. If you want to know more or you are interested in similar videos like this on this channel, let me know down below. But apart from that, thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.